Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I want to ask you about
sebutkan nama dan profesi.
My name is Dewi Nurhayati. I work in a supermarket and store. And I want to ask you about the non-Muslim's opinion, the non-Muslim's assumption. I heard this assumption since a long time, and now is the right time to ask. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, had been politicalized this religion to make Arab nations wealthy. As we know, the Muslim all around the world save money to go Hajj, to go Umrah, and it makes the Arab and getting rich. And I don't have any enough education to deny this assumption. This is my question for you.
The sister has the question that she has the assumption that we have to go for Hajj. And when we go for Hajj, the Arab nations become richer. So is this correct? This is the question, sister, correct? Sister, first let me tell you one thing. I don't know of any country in the world like Saudi Arabia which spends billions of dollars only for maintaining of the Haramain and the Hajj. I don't know, even the Vatican City, the Pope, they, even when you go there to the church, you have to pay money. Here, mashallah, always the visa for Hajj and the visa for Umrah have always been free, 100%. It is lately, a few months back, they started that if you want to go multiple times, then they will charge you. That also they just started a few months before. The amount of money they spend only to keep one day of Makkah Haram alone open is maybe $1 million. The amount of money they spend in cleaning, the amount of money they spend on electrician, amount of money they spend on the sound system, the amount of money they spend in the construction. They spend billions of dollars, sister. For you to lay an allegation that because they have Makkah, they are making money is 100% wrong, sister. Have you been to Makkah, sister? Have you been to Makkah?
Not yet.
So how can you lay an allegation that they're making money?
I heard that assumption from the non-Muslim.
Okay, just because you heard the assumption, you ask them for
and
proof. Allah says in the Quran, "Kul hatu burhanakum in kuntum sadikin." Produce your proof, but if you're truthful. This is totally allegation to malign the Muslim faith. Alhamdulillah, the amount of money that Saudi Arabia spends to maintain the Makkah and Medina, the Haramain, and the Mina, etc., and Arafat for Hajj, it is phenomenal. Now, recently, few months back, they started saying that, okay, if you want to do multiple times, Farz is only once. If you want to go again for Hajj, then they will charge you. The first Hajj is free. Same with Umrah. Multiple times if you want to do, then they will charge you a visa fee, which is yet comparatively less as compared to the other countries what they charge. So I feel that what service they are doing as a country for the Haramain is a blessing for the Muslim Ummah. So you have to pray for them, not speak against them. Hope that answers the question, sister.
May I have one small question?
But do you agree what you have done is wrong?
I agree, but yes. I don't have enough education to deny them.
To deny them what?
To deny that assumption. But now...
Now you know, correct?
Now okay. I know.
Very good, sister.
May so I next have one more questions?
Sister, for second question, go behind the queue.
Okay.
There are many sisters waiting. Go behind the queue, and if your time comes, we'll give you, inshallah.